Good afternoon to all. I welcome you in digital class of biology. So students, today I will start with my first chapter, that is the fundamental unit of life. But before that, I would like to state what Krishna says. He says that if you fail to achieve your goal, change the strategy and not the goal. For example, if you don't understand any topic in any of the subject, just try to change the strategy and not your topic. I hope the thing is clear to you. So here I'll begin with my first chapter, that is the fundamental unit of life. First of all, I would like to start with the discovery of cell. Okay, and this I would like to start with a small story that what happened while examining a thin slice of cork. Okay, Robert Hooke saw that the cork resembled the structure of a honeycomb consisting of many little compartments. Now the question arises that what is a cork? Students, cork is a substance which comes from the bark of a tree. This was in the year 1665 when Hooke made this chance observation through a self-designed microscope. Okay, and Robert Hooke called these boxes as cell. And the cell is a Latin word for a little room. This may seem to be a very small and insignificant incident, but it is very important in the history of science. This was the very first time that someone had observed that living things appear to consist of separate units. The use of the word cell to describe these units is used till this day in biology. Okay, now we know that there is something cell, but the question is arising in our mind that what are the different gadgets through which we can study these cells? Those gadgets were your microscope. Okay, two common types of microscope that you need to know are light microscope and electron microscope. Now what are these microscopes? These are high resolution instruments, okay, that are used for observing fine details of very minute objects. Clear? And cells are also too small to be seen by the naked eye, thus they are seen with the help of microscope. What is cell? Cell is the structural and functional unit of life. And on the basis of the number of cells, organism can be of two types, that is unicellular organism and multicellular organism. What are unicellular? Uni means one, multi means many. Okay, so those organisms which are made up of single cell are known as unicellular, and the organisms which are made up of many cells are known as multicellular organism. Clear? In case of unicellular, single cell have the ability to perform all the life processes, whereas in case of multicellular, different cell perform different activities. Clear? Example of unicellular are amoeba and paramecium, and that of multicellular are plant, animals and fungi. There is need to know about the history of a cell. I would like to start it with Robert Hooke, who in 1665 discovered the cell. After that, A. van Leeuwenhoek in 1674 studied the living cell for the first time. Robert Brown in 1831 discovered the structure called nucleus inside the cell. Schilden and Schwann in 1838 and 39 stated the cell theory, whereas Rudolf Virchow in 1855 stated omnicellula e cellula, which means that cell arise from pre-existing cells. See student, multicellular organism have different kinds of cell. Look at the picture. It depicts some cell from the human body. Clear? Each living cell has the capacity to perform certain basic functions that are characteristics of all living forms. How does a living cell perform these basic functions? We know that there is a division of labor in multiple organisms such as human beings. This means that different parts of the human body perform different functions. The human body has a heart to pump blood, a stomach to digest food, and so on. Okay. And in turn, all these organs are made up of a cell. Okay, and cell in turn is made up of different organelles. Clear? So you can simply say that cell is made up of three parts, that is plasma membrane, also known as cell membrane, nucleus and cytoplasm. Clear? So I hope the concept is clear to you. Okay, today we have just took the introduction of your chapter. Okay, and you have to do your notes. In that I have given you some questions, okay, solved questions are there, such as who discovered cell and how, why is the cell called the structural and function unit of life. Till now you must be able to know these two three questions. Also one more question, that is unicellular and multicellular organism, what are these? Okay, these three four questions are very much important for your board point of view. Okay students, so I hope so that you will complete your notes and also learn this question. Okay, for any query please do call me. Thank you and have a nice day.